Hey YouTube Gecko Guy here. So I'm going to be talking about what are some good beginner reptiles, you know, reptiles, amphibians, geckos, that sort of stuff. Anybody who's anybody will recommend a leopard gecko, and that is what I first started as for my first reptile, and still to this day he's my oldest living reptile and I've had him the longest, and he's been through hell and back and through a couple of vet trips and all sorts of stuff, but he's still doing good. He's about to be 10 years old here in December, so that would be very interesting, and I can't wait for that. But leopard geckos, yes, they are a very good reptile to first start with, like if you're just getting into it. They don't require a lot of space, and you can get away with a 20-gallon setup for just about $100 with the gecko included if you go to Petco or something like that. And then there's the... should you buy from a reptile vendor at an expo, or should you just go to Petco? It's hit or miss either way. I've had a couple of bad reptiles from both reptile expos as well as pet stores, retail pet stores, that kind of a deal. So it's just kind of preference. You just, you know, always want to make sure that the gecko is alert and, you know, looks very well fed, look for a plumpy tail. If we're talking about like leopard geckos and other clawed geckos, you know, no stuck shed, no poop smeared on them if they're not walking funny. That could be a calcium deficiency, that sort of stuff. You want to make sure that they're a healthy looking gecko, and you know, ask if you can see a feeding demonstration, like have them put in a dozen or so and see which one goes for a bunch of them. Because it's kind of like survival of the fittest in those little cubicles that they put them in. Leopard geckos are a very good reptile to start with. Crested geckos are now making a kind of a big turnaround. You see them more and more often. Here in Wisconsin and Illinois, it's mostly crested gecko and ball python breeders, and then the various other reptile breeders kind of have like a little hodgepodge. A little bit of everything sort of deal, that sort of deal, and I do have a crested gecko. I just have one crested gecko. They are very interesting little geckos to own. They are completely arboreal, but the thing about crested geckos is you have to start them in very small little plastic containers and then work your way up as they grow. Now a leopard gecko and other geckos like the African fat tails, you can have them in a larger cage, like a 20-gallon long, their whole lifetime, and they should be just fine. Now with the crested gecko, if you have them in a smaller or in a bigger cage and they're just a little little baby, they get a little they can get kind of stressed and they can't really find the food that easily, so you could wind up with a dead gecko on your hands. Now leopard gecko, crested gecko, and African fat tails, be different. I'd say start with an African fat tail gecko. It's basically the exact same care as a leopard gecko. Just keep a little higher humidity in the cage. So just missing the cage, dumping a little bit of water, on the substrate. I use paper towel, and I think everybody should use paper towel, but that's just me. Now I do have a tokay gecko, and I do not recommend that as a first reptile because they need very large cages. Just for one, I'm just using a 29-gallon tank, and they are very vicious. I have to wear a gardening glove because they are they have a very powerful bite. Yes, it is possible to tame them, but it's very hard to do. And 2.5 years later, I still have to wear the gardening glove because there's just no possible way for me to make friends with my tokay gecko. And then some of those off geckos like the tokay gecko, skunk gecko, ocelot gecko, panther gecko, same thing. Some of them are wild caught, but not always. Panther geckos are now starting to make a show their face in the reptile industry, and I had one. I bought one from a breeder, and for a while it was going pretty good, and then just kind of died on me. And I talked to one of my subscribers. She had a panther gecko, and she said she was doing all the right stuff, and then just kind of died on her as well. So I don't necessarily recommend you do panther geckos, but that could be a second gecko that you could look into. Now, if you want to have a gecko that does not require lighting or any sort of heat that boosts the electricity bill, definitely go with a crested gecko. But if you don't really mind that, a leopard gecko, African fat-tailed, and maybe a Chinese cave gecko if you can find them, those would be okay starters. But, what are your beginner reptiles? These are just kind of gecko comparisons. I know there's a whole bunch of them out there that you could do, like blue-tongued skinks. You can do bearded dragons, although those guys need very big cages. They are a very good reptile to start off with. So, be sure to leave a comment in the comment section below. Tell me what your thoughts and, what beginner reptile you guys started with. YouTube gecko guy here. So, if you're in the market and you're